Today's our topic is about chapter number 2, fractions and decimals. This is not a very new topic for you. Already you know some knowledge about fractions and decimals. Here in this chapter we are going to learn newly about multiplication and division of fractions. Even multiplication and division of decimals. Already you learnt addition subtraction of fractions and also addition subtraction of decimals. We will also recap those all the points, that is addition subtraction of fractions and also kinds of fractions and what is the use of fractions and decimals in our daily life. Let us see where we use the fractions and decimals in our daily life. See this example. In this clock, what is the time, children? 3 o'clock. In this clock, it is 2:45, or you can also say 3:15. This quarter is nothing but 1/4. 3:15. There, in case of time also, we are using decimal. We are using fractions concept. Next, if you see recipes, some of the recipes you can see ingredients they'll be giving in this manner: 1 cup of sugar, 1.5 cup of milk, 1/4 cups of ice cream powder is needed to prepare ice cream. Like that, you can observe the ingredients list for the recipes. Even decimals also useful in money. Let us suppose 25 rupees. You can represent 25 rupees as like this also. 25 rupees, 50 paise, how you will represent? 25 rupees, 50 paise. Like this. Like this we can use the decimals in money. And also weight, length, measurements, these all the concept we need the concept of decimals. And even both the concepts of fractions and decimals are useful in higher classes also. To learn the concepts which are there in higher classes, we must be very clear with fractions and decimals. Discuss the points whatever you learnt in previous classes about fractions. In previous classes you learnt about fractions. What is a fraction, children? Actually, fraction is a part of whole. Fraction is a part of a whole. This fraction word is derived actually from a Latin word, fractus. What is it? Fractus. What is the meaning of fractus? Which means broken. Fractus means broken. Fraction is a part of a whole. And fraction word is derived from the Latin word fractus, which means broken. And you also learnt about different types of fractions. That is proper, improper and also mixed. Proper fraction, all of you know, numerator is less than denominator. Numerator is less than denominator. For example, 1/2, 3/4, etc. What is improper fraction? Just opposite to this. That is, denominator will be smaller, or else you can see numerator is greater than denominator. For example, you can also observe 4/3, 7/5, etc. And also, what about if numerator and denominator both are equal? Then also we'll call them as improper fractions only. That is, let us suppose 5/5 is there. This also will come under improper fractions only. So now you can see about mixed fractions. Mixed fractions are combination of whole numbers and proper fraction. Whole number plus proper. Suppose, example, if you see 3 1/2. Here this is whole part, this is proper fraction. Whole number, proper fraction. Combination of these two will give you mixed fraction, 5, 7 by 8, etc. These mixed fractions can be also expressed into improper fraction, and improper fractions also can be expressed into mixed fraction. Both can be written like this. Suppose once you can see how to represent, how to write or how to express improper to mixed fraction. You already learnt 7 by 5, just you divide 7 with 5. So, 1s are, it is 5, it is 2. Now, you will write this as mixed fraction like 1, 2 by 5. And how to convert a mixed fraction into improper fraction? Let us take the same example, 3, 1 by 2. Here, you have to multiply these two and you need to add the result here. The denominator will remain same. You should not change the denominator. Same denominator will come up even for the result. That means 2 3s are 6. 6 plus 1 is 7. 7. 7 by 2. 3 1 by 2 also can be expressed as 7 by 2. Not only these children, you also learnt about some more types of fractions, that is like fractions. What is it? Like. And unlike also you learnt. Unlike fractions also you learnt. What are like fractions? The fractions which have the same denominator are like fractions. Like 7 by 2, 3 by 2, 5 by 2, 1 by 2, etc. All these are having the denominators as 2. So, all these are examples for like fractions. What are unlike fractions? The fractions with different denominators. Let us suppose 7 by 2, 2 by 3, 2 by 5, 2 by 1, etc. These all are having different denominators. So, what do you call all these fractions? Unlike fractions. Like fractions, unlike fractions. And also you can observe unit fractions. You also learnt about unit fractions. You also learnt about unit fractions. What are unit fractions? The fractions with the numerator 1. 1 by 3, 1 by 7, 1 by 5, 1 by 2, etc. are with the numerators 1. Numerators equal to 1. So, they are called unit fractions. Then, decimal fractions. What are decimal fractions? The fractions with, suppose, 3 divided by, 4 divided by, 7 divided by, like these fractions are there. The denominators has to be 10, 100 or 1000. Etc. The fractions with the denominators 10, 100, 1000, etc. are decimal fractions. This is all about fractions that you have learnt in previous classes.